The deficit is right down. The economy is growing. We're creating jobs. Britain is making things again and making its way in the world again. 2.4 million more people in work. We've got low inflation. We've almost got a million more businesses than when we first got our jobs in 2010. But yes, we still have a long way to go. Yes, there is more to do. But I think there can be no doubt Britain is on the right track. Now, I don't want us to do anything that sets us on the wrong track. Someone actually asked in this debate the other day, you know, that's the economic case. What about the moral case? But don't they realize the economic case is the moral case? The moral case for keeping parents in work, firms in business, the pound in health, Britain in credit. The moral case for providing economic opportunity rather than unemployment for the next generation. Where is the morality in putting any of that at risk for some unknown end? This government was elected just over a year ago to deliver security at every stage of life, to build a greater Britain out of a great recession. And after all the pain, all the sacrifice of the British people, why would we want to put it at risk again? It would be like surviving a fall and then running straight back to the cliff edge. It is the self-destruct option. Now, so much of this debate is muddied and overshadowed by speculation about who says what about whom and who's in this camp or that camp. We need to strip away the drama and focus on real life, because this isn't about political parties or personalities or prime ministers. It's about you, about your money and your life. The stakes couldn't be higher, the risks couldn't be greater, and in my view, the choice couldn't be clearer. Leave Europe and put at risk what we've achieved. Stay in Europe and stay on the right track.